Today, I'm going to share with you 5 ways that you can stay in touch, connected, remotely, virtually, online, using applications that you already have in your phone. Most likely, they're already installed. And if you haven't installed them, well, you can just go to the App Store, find them, and install them. So now more than ever, we're going to have that need to stay connected somehow, because we're not going to be able to go visit our friends, visit our family, just congregate with our community, our coworkers, our associates, partners, events, whatever it is that you are going to be attending that now is either canceled or you have been discouraged from doing that traveling or going to that event. We're living in different times. It changes day to day, almost hour by hour in certain cases. I'm in Northern California, and a few days ago, we were issued the order, not everywhere, but in 6 counties. I happen to live in one of the 6 counties where we were issued an order to stay home and not to leave our homes for 3 weeks, except for the necessary going grocery shopping, the gas station, the doctor's appointments, or something like that. We had already been preparing for that, so it didn't hit us as hard, except for the fact that I personally have a few corporate consulting clients that I go into their physical offices, and we weren't quite ready for that. So I'm still having to go there, pick up a few things, and get everybody situated so they can work remotely. So you start to lose some of this connectivity, connection, community. And I want to give you a few ideas as to how you can stay connected. I'm going to go over 5 things that I actually use in my personal and professional life, in my business, with my clients, with my friends, with my family, and my neighbors even, actually. So I want to make sure that you know that you don't have to use all of these tools, but a lot of them are available to you for free, and some are even very budget friendly, but I'm not going over any paid ones today. So here we go. My name is Veronica Sagastumi, and I actually have an offline, face-to-face, in-person consulting side of my business. I provide CFO services for startup companies in the Silicon Valley and San Francisco, the Bay Area. And the other side of my business is where I have an online business where I work virtually online with accounting professionals, helping them to start their own consulting business. So as you can see, I have both sides, and I have been very fortunate in that I have been using tools both from in my online space. I use some of my offline techniques, and in my offline practice, I've been really incorporating a lot of the online tools, resources, and applications that I use daily in order for my clients to feel like they always have access to me. I'm readily available. I can turn things around very quickly, and everybody gets taken care of. And sometimes I don't have to travel anywhere except to my office, like I am doing right now. All right, without further ado, I'm going to be bringing a lot of different tips during this series of what I'm calling hashtag offline to online. So today is all about staying connected remotely, virtually, however you want to call it, online. The first one is FaceTime, using your phone. We don't use our phones very often for the actual purpose of what it was meant to call somebody. We can call or we can FaceTime. Now, more and more I'm FaceTiming with my relatives that I haven't seen in a while, and I had thought I was going to travel to go see them. And FaceTime, just, you know, when you call somebody to check if you have it, call, and when the caller picks up, the icon that says FaceTime will show up. You can do that through a tablet or through an iPhone. And if you get tired of holding it up and you don't have a tripod like I do, then you can always prop up a couple of books. I'm doing right now, prop up a couple of books on top of it and behind it so that you don't have to hold it the whole time. That allows you to see the other person, have a great conversation, and stay connected. Do you like it? So far, so good. Let's go on to number 2. Number 2 would be group texts. Now, I've never been a great big fan of group texts because it starts to get a little bit out of hand. I'm going to make an exception because group texts are a great way for a group of us. Like, I have a group text going on with some of my neighbors, a group text going on with some colleagues, and a group text going on, I haven't started it, but I've started to do it right before I recorded this video, with my girlfriends, because I think that it's important that we stay in touch, especially if, let me just share with you the neighborhood group text is when one of us is out. Maybe we're at the bank or at the grocery store or at the gas station. Is one of those errands that we're running that we absolutely have to do. Well, maybe we can pick up something for somebody else. Hey, I'm on my way to the bank. Does anybody need anything? I'm at the grocery store and they have shelves of canned goods. Do you guys want me to pick up something? You see how you start to support and be there for each other, but you're still connected. You feel like you're supporting each other, even though we have this social distancing going on right now for our own health and our own good. We are absolutely in favor of this because it's going to slow down the spread of this corona virus. So now, I want to make sure that we don't overabuse this, that we don't, you know, overuse it to the point where you become annoying or you're annoyed. And it's not about that. It is about picking a few people that you want to definitely stay in touch with, check in on, check up on, but you can't do it physically. Even to the point where you could do so by going up to the person's house, home, wherever they're at, and using, whether it's FaceTime, the first one that I used, or a group text to communicate. So again, you already have that in your iPhone or your smartphone. You should be able to do a call on FaceTime, a calling number one, or you can do a group text, which is number two. Moving on to number three. It's not a tool that I use except for when I go on vacation, but now I'm using it for day-to-day life. WhatsApp. WhatsApp is owned by Facebook. So it's already, you know, part of that whole social media bundle. So go ahead and use it, because let me tell you how I've been using it. I use it with relatives who are in Brush Prairie, Washington, in Oregon, in Georgia, in another country. Because what we do is we either send a photo, we send an audio message, or we send a video, quick one. And I've been using all of that for the past week. And let me tell you, everybody feels good. You know, I'm able to give them updates and they're able to give me updates, especially if we have a sick relative right now and we're not able to actually be there except for one of us. So let me just recap very quickly. The first resource I'm talking about is your iPhone, but using FaceTime so that you have a connection with the person that you're calling and speaking to in real time. The next one would be group text. And again, that's a great way for you to have different group texts going for community purposes, for you to be supportive of each other, but also share tips or does anybody know how to do this? Or what are you guys doing to keep your kids busy during this time? Hey, I'm having to homeschool for the first time. What are you guys doing? This is how we can all come together, support each other, and stay connected as a community during a time where we're going to start feeling isolated here very shortly. All right, and the third one I just shared was WhatsApp. WhatsApp I love because you can do one person or a group of people. They can be local and in other countries, and you can share a picture, an audio, or a video, or just a good old text in WhatsApp. Great, right? Let's go on to number four. Number four, I'm calling virtual chats. This is more on the professional chat side. There are times when I just would like to reach out and see how my peeps are doing, whether it's ex-clients, colleagues, associates, friends that I've met and been working with and connected online, but now we're not in our regular group sessions or masterminds or what have you. So one of the things that we can do a virtual chat through Skype or Zoom, and we schedule it and we come on, and just like you're seeing me here, we can see each other and talk about what's going on, maybe brainstorm some things with our business. I actually have like a group call going on next Tuesday with a set of ladies that we meet every 2 weeks. And I'm so happy that I get to do that because I can really look forward to seeing them. And again, we're all in a Zoom chat room and we see all the little boxes like a Brady Bunch style, if you remember that. So the virtual coffee chats is more for, you know, 15, 20 minutes. You don't have to have a bunch of them. You can do just one other person, or you can do a group of people just so that you guys can support each other. And again, maybe brainstorm as to what things are going on in your business, what needs to change, maybe run some ideas by each other so that you can then support each other. Because let me tell you, in the online space, no one really understands all of the things that we deal with, all of the moving pieces that we have to connect and maneuver and manage every single day, except for another online business owner. So don't disregard those coffee chats. If you don't drink coffee, make it a tea chat or make it a wine chat, which leads me to number five, host a happy hour. Host an online happy hour with your friends, with your relatives, with your sister. Basically, a happy hour could be hosted through Skype or Zoom. Both of those tools are available to you online and they are free. I have the paid versions, but you know, don't worry about that. You can get it for free and you can host it. And I think Zoom, you can have up to a 40-minute group call, you know, and you can each have your favorite beverage. It doesn't have to be alcohol. It can be something else, but then that is a time for you guys to come together. What's going on at home? How are you dealing with kids being at home or your significant other, having to share space, no quiet time, running a business, or just staying insane because maybe you have the kind of job where you can't actually work at home. I can think of many of my friends who need to be at their shop or at their store or at their restaurant, and they're not able to take their work home. So they're stuck at home, and maybe that happy hour is not only a relief, but also a time for you guys to brainstorm and figure out, hey, what else could I be doing? I'm gonna have other tips during the series that I'm calling hashtag offline to online. But today was to deal with what other things you could be doing at home during this time. That especially if you have some downtime or you're not working full time because there's only so much you can do from home. But today I wanted to share 5 ways that you can stay connected with your family, with your friends, with your colleagues, with your team, with your clients, associates, partners, anybody you want to. And actually, I'm gonna have a bonus one because I love GIFs. That's my love language, I think, the online love language. And just yesterday, I sent a few of my ex-employees who are actually friends of mine now. They know I have an online business. They don't really get to see that much of me in person or at conferences that they attend, but we stay connected. We send each other funny GIFs all the time. And now more than ever, we are keeping our sense of humor, and at random times and inopportune times, it's not about getting upset like they're disrupting my day. It's a welcome break. It's a welcome, a humorous break that somebody was thinking of me to send me a GIF. So to recap, 6 ways to stay connected with everybody in your life, not everybody at once. Take it easy. Don't go giving me all these messages. When are we supposed to do any work? This is just for you guys when you start feeling isolated. Think about somebody who may be feeling that way even more so. Okay, number 1, FaceTime. Whoever you're calling through your phone, hey, push that button and get on the phone. So nobody cares what you look like. So just get on the FaceTime. The other one is group text for different groups for different reasons. Don't abuse it, don't overuse it, but it's a good way to stay connected. Number 3 would be to use the WhatsApp application. Again, you could send a text or an audio or a video or a picture. It's a little bit more real time like it is FaceTime, but still it's available there. Again, you can do it with one person or a group of people. Number 4, I think we're up to number 4, virtual coffee chats with more for business and associates or employees or colleagues. And again, you can do it for one person or a group of people. I'm sure a lot of people are gonna be craving that kind of connection. Number 5 would be to host a happy hour with your friends to brainstorm as to what else everybody else is doing to maneuver, to navigate these unknown, uncertain waters. And my bonus one was send an unexpected GIF. Everybody loves to get something funny. Send a GIF yourself and they'll reciprocate, and it's a nice little break. So that's all I've got for you today. I hope that these were helpful. I'm sure there are so many other ways. So if you want to share some with us, go ahead and leave them in the comments wherever you're watching this video. And again, stay safe, stay healthy. And I'll speak to you soon with my series called hashtag offline to online. I'm going to just share a bunch of tips with you on how to work remotely or virtually, however you want to refer to it, from home, because now we are being asked not to go to the office. We can't go to the office space or the workspace that we're used to, or even the coffee shops where we like to hang out at. So I'm Veronica, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.